my channel. Today we'll be painting a strawberry, which I haven't done for my tutorials. I haven't done any tutorial for a strawberry, and I remember I've painted some strawberries before, you know, before my YouTube channel started. But now I want to show you how I paint a realistic strawberry. We'll do our best to make this as realistic as possible because I intend to share some skills in painting. So let's begin now, guys. I'm quite excited about this one because this is my very first time to show you how to paint a strawberry. And I really don't know how this will turn out, but I think that's the most exciting part about this. Let me tell you the colors now that we'll be using for today's tutorial. So, we have here, okay, cadmium orange, cadmium yellow, burnt sienna red, and phthalo green, and maybe I'll use some tiny bit of black. I really don't know if this will be of use to me, but I might use it because this strawberry doesn't have a lot of dark colors, but I might use, all right? I really don't know. Maybe I will, but as we go on, we will find out if I'll be using that color. Just have this color ready so that, you know, if I decide to use it, then it's just right beside you. So let's begin. I'm going to use my pencil to sketch first the subject. And for this subject, we'll be using, or for this painting, we'll be using the white background as is. You don't have to paint your background or to paint your canvas black or anything in particular. So we'll be doing a strawberry like this. Again, I'm freehand sketching everything. And since this is just the sketch, this might change because I always have this tendency to do large paintings. That's why the proportion is quite big. But then again, I will make some adjustments if necessary. These are the green part, right? So there you go. All right, so that will basically compose the shape of this strawberry. Again, this is just the sketch. It may change later as we do the painting, but for now, let's just do the general shape of what we're trying to do here. All right. So now that I've sketched it, the general shape of it, I'm gonna underpaint now my strawberry. Okay. Let me just fix my... Okay, all right, so let's begin now. For the underpainting, I'm gonna use my burnt sienna. Oh, sorry guys. I'm gonna use my burnt sienna, all right? Okay, add tiny bit of red. Okay, and let's begin underpainting it. As you can see, it's quite reddish already. That's because burnt sienna and red, I think this is a good underpainting color for a strawberry. I'm just removing. All right. All This is just the underpainting, so you don't have to worry too much. At this stage of our painting, it only sets the background. It only sets some shadows and depth. No detailing yet. Right, like that. All right, then I'm gonna switch to my orange color. Right, so get your orange and underpaint the topmost portion of the strawberry with the orange color. It's like a gradient effect from orange to red. Like so. All right, like that. So that's the underpainting for our strawberry. Okay, and then we're going to allow this first to dry, just to be sure that when we do the details, we don't mix the colors, the underpainting and the second layer. All right, so we're going to allow this first to dry. Now let's move on to the greeny part. So wash your brush out, get your phthalo green, okay, add some tiny bit of black. Now we're using black, guys, so just add tiny bit of black, tiny bit of yellow, and start doing some underpainting of the leaves. I'm calling it leaves. I know that they are not leaves, they are like the crown of the strawberry. Next, we're going to do it here. And then we're going to do some detailing later. For now, let's just allow this to dry. All right, next, so. So that's basically the shape of this strawberry. It kind of looks good already. Kind of like it. And we're going to delete some, you know, some areas that don't have to be here. Like this extra sketch that I did, we can delete that. First, I'm just gonna fix this one. All right. Now I'm gonna get my yellow. So get your yellow. Maybe add tiny bit of white. I don't think I prepared my white. I think I forgot to mention that we'll be using white for this painting. Sorry about that. But yeah, definitely I haven't done any painting that doesn't have any white paint. So just get your white plus yellow. And again, just try to lighten this portion. All And of course, you can use your fingers for easier application. And it's okay if the green is quite mixing, because that's what we want. Some sort of blending. All right, like that. All right. Okay. Now I'm going to get my orange plus red. Okay. Just mix your orange and red. And we're going to do the second underpainting. Here. So I'm switching from red to orange, and of course I'm using my hand, my fingers in blending, because I kind of like the effect of finger painting when I'm trying to blend. All right, I'm gonna add a tiny bit of white. Just to lighten this area. Right. Okay, like that. Some orange, and also we're going to lighten the bottom portion by mixing orange and red. Like so. And I think the hardest part in painting a strawberry is the detailing when we do the little dots. Yeah, for sure, you know what I'm talking about, the little seeds on the strawberry. I think that's the hardest part. So let's do it now, because once we're done, then it's done. Okay, for that, okay, I'm going to use the tip of my brush. Oops. All right, I'm going to use the tip of my brush. I'm gonna dab onto my burnt sienna. Add tiny bit of red, maybe tiny bit of black, like this. And let's start doing some detailing. I'm making the edge quite irregularly shaped so that, you know, we follow the rules of nature here. Nature is usually irregular when it comes to shapes. All right, so by using black and brown, we're going to make some detailing. This might be the hardest part of this painting, but I'm gonna do my best. I don't mind if I spend, I don't know, hours in doing this detailing. Just create some tiny dots.
So this is quite repetitive, as you can see. Do some dots. Here, so you don't have to go crazy over this step. Just make some dots and make them quite arranged in a particular pattern. It's like diagonal. And when you're done, let's proceed with some more detailing, and this is going to make it easier. I want you to get your white, titanium white, okay, tiny bit of orange perhaps, and red. Let's try to make some more detailing. Okay. This will suggest some shine. So here, now we're going to the center of some dots or seeds, if you want to call that seeds. I don't know what they're called, but I think they are seeds. They look like seeds to me. Like that. Okay, what's your brush out? Just to thin the paint, because it's kind of getting thicker already. So I'm going to add some shine. Right. Okay, I'm going to add some tiny bit of yellow and orange colors here. I'm going to highlight the bottom portion. Like so. All right, and now let's wait for the paint to dry a bit and then let's proceed to some leaves. So I'm gonna make some yellow green color. Get your green, get your yellow. Okay, add a tiny bit of white and let's create some detailing right here. That. Going to get some black and let's darken some areas. Add some depth. So, wash your brush out, get some yellow, cadmium yellow. Again, cadmium yellow. I'm going to get my cad orange, add a tiny bit of white and maybe red. And then let's use this to create some more layers of colors. Just to add more highlights. I really wonder how this looks like. I'm gonna check.
All right, so we'll do a little bit more detailing because we're just 27 minutes in. So I'm gonna go and highlight some more.
I'm gonna get my pure white. I'm going to highlight some more. I'm using watered down white, by the way. Oops. Let's make some pink color. So red, okay, plus white. Let's try to use this color. Going to get my burnt sienna. Maybe add a tiny bit of yellow to that. It's just, oops. So burnt sienna plus yellow. And we're going to lighten some areas, some dots. Just go around those black dots that we did. Should be a little random. I'm gonna get my white. Right.
I really don't know how this looks like already.
Okay, wash your brush out. And I think I have to use my hair dryer. Areas with some dark colors. So I'm gonna get my reddish brown color. Okay. And use a lot of water for this step. Add a tiny bit of black because we're going to glaze now. Since everything is dry. So I'm gonna glaze the middle portion with this color. Like so. Now I'm gonna get my orange and I'm gonna glaze this topmost portion. Again, just glazing, guys. Glazing, you don't really paint over what you've painted on already. You're just trying to cover, like using a translucent paper or plastic. And same down here, just glaze. I'm going to darken this area. Whoops. Okay, now let's go back to highlighting some areas. I'm gonna get my white, just pure white, guys. Let's go back to detailing. So I'm just gonna go around this area. Going to make some more shading up here. I'm going to get some black. All right. We're going to outline the strawberry by just going around the strawberry. Gonna use red. All right, wash your brush out. And I'm going to delete some paints that went outside my sketch. I'm gonna use my hair dryer just to dry things a little bit quicker. Gonna get my cadmium yellow plus burnt sienna. Just going to darken some areas right here just to make it look a little more natural. All right, like that. I'm going to mix some red and black. So I'm just trying to make some depth. So mix yellow and white. and then green. So just use some yellow greeny color. Then I'm going to use pure black. And then try to outline it. I'm gonna get my cadmium yellow plus white. All right, try to blend. Okay, you know, I have some like bugs walking around because I'm near my plants. I'm painting near my plants right now. How does this look like? Oh, that's quite better, right? Oh, this is better, getting better, guys. Okay. Going to use more pinky color. It's actually Friday here right now, which I am just so excited about because, you know, tomorrow is of course my favorite day, Saturday. Okay, I'm gonna add some yellowish seeds. gonna get my red, and I'm gonna dab on some reddish color. And some pinky colors. Going to mix some green and black, just a tiny bit. Okay, there's a bug. So I'm gonna use some watered down whites just to add some light or highlights right here on the left, on the right side. It's just glazing it with white. Gonna add some reds right here. All right, I'm thinking of putting some shadows. I'm thinking So I think for the shadow, I'm just gonna add, I'm gonna get some gray color. So let's make some gray color. Maybe add a tiny bit of red or pink. So just go right under the strawberry. I'm gonna get my white. And let's just, you know, like go back to outlining it. Like that. Just so it has that surface to sit on. All right. Now, since there is shadow here, the light should be striking this side. So I'm going to lighten a bit. I'm going to get my pink color, so red plus white. Let's try to make it quite bright. going to get my cad yellow. And some white. And some orange. All right, wash your brush out. Again, just get your white. Highlight even more. So now we're highlighting the left side, because if the shadow is down here, the light should be coming from here. And of course, the leaves or the crown should be bright as well on the left side. Like so, kind of like it now. Okay, wash your brush out. And I think I need more white. And we're going to use this white to make some more highlights. Make sure to water down your white. All right, wash your brush out, and then I'm going to get my dark red color. So red plus black or burnt sienna. Right, we're going to use that to darken this side. Like so. Then we're going to make some black dots. Just to be consistent where the light is. Gonna make some pink color. And again, just go around those black dots. Not go around, but halfway. Like making the letter C.
painting.
Get your white. We're going to make some more detailing.
Like so. Oh, this is nice.
I'm just removing the hard lines on the shadow area. Just try to soften it a bit. Let's darken the bottom portion because it's actually resting on the surface, so the light should not be really reaching that area. Not as much.
Like that. Oh, I like this one.
Yeah, that's what I want to give it.
like this. I like this, guys.
Oops. Just gonna glaze it with some red color. I know that we did a lot of techniques here, but as I told you guys, I haven't really done a strawberry for my tutorials. This is the very first time and I kind of like the result.
At first I was already pessimistic about it because
at first, guys, I don't know if you can rewind the video.
Oh my gosh, I love it. I love it, guys. Oh my gosh.
I'm gonna add tiny hints of reds down here. Just to be coherent when it comes to the colors. Like that. I really like this one. Oh my gosh.
All right, now I have to sign this now. So
I'm gonna use, I don't know if I will sign it now. Maybe I'm gonna obsess a little bit more with some highlights. I'm gonna glaze it with more white. Right here. I kind of like the light play that I did here. It's actually unexpected. It's sometimes we do things, you know, unexpectedly.
And I really like the result. I just love the result.
All right. I think I have to sign this now because it's done. This is absolutely done. Maybe if there's some other things that need to be done, maybe that just deleting those areas or those paints that went outside my outline just to clean it. Again, just clean your painting.
I love it. I love it. Oh my gosh. I have to sign this now. Because if I don't sign it already, I'm going to obsess a little bit more over the details. Okay. So I'm going to sign it now. I'm going to use my black and sign it right here. And we're done, guys. We're done, guys. Oh my gosh. I really like this painting. I really like this tutorial. I hope you enjoy this one, and I hope you do this one as well. See you in my next video, guys. And love you.